Hi, Mal. I'm just by myself in my car. There's a man sitting in his car behind me, and I'm 99% sure he's not filming a video, but who knows? Everyone's a YouTuber these days. So, I do not have an aux cord. So, I went on an adventure and I bought way too many CDs. I spent way too much money on them. I spent $150 on CDs. And that's because
I
couldn't decide like on the ones that I didn't want. So this is gonna be a little bit of a haul. I always wanted to do a haul. My mind. But before we do the haul, when I got back into my car to listen to all of my new brand new CDs, I open the CD compartment and there's a CD in there already. Ultimate Kylie is what it's called. So I assumed Kylie Jenner, obviously, but although she doesn't make music to my knowledge. And then I look a little closer and it says copyright 2004. So I gave it a little listen, and by a little listen, I mean 20 seconds, and it was just bad. I don't know what to do with that. I said little haul before, I meant big haul because this is a lot. So, there it is. There she is. My new CD selection. Collection. Okay, first, we got some good old Sufjan. They didn't have my fave Sufjan album, which. When I said that, I'm hoping you knew it was Karen Lowell, obviously. Next, some Stevie Wonder. Greatest Hits Collection. Once in eighth grade, I wrote a paper about him. And ever since then, that was not going anywhere at all. I wanted to have some sort of backstory, but really that's it. Yeah, great album, Far. Dirty Projectors. I think it's called Bitta Orca. A freaking dank album. If you have not listened to it, listen to it. Dirty Projectors are just iconic. And honestly, like, I think they're musical geniuses. So, yep. Next, we got some Beach Boys Pet Sounds. I just imagined myself, like, going on a sweet ass road trip down like beautiful coast of Australia and bumping this and like just really loving my life. So, got that. Angus and Julia Stone. They're so good. I don't know if you listen to them either, but wow. Beautiful, beautiful album. Down the Way is what it's called. Two Vampire Weekends because.
You know, I saw a tweet the other day that was like. Vampire Weekend is threatening to release me new music. And have we gotten to the point where we're making fun of people for liking Vampire Weekend? Because I'm not into that.
The Beatles. Okay. You can make fun of this one. That's fine. Rubber Soul, my favorite album. Lana! Born to Die. I mean, there's nothing to say here. Essential. A find that I was truly ecstatic about. Mini Drake, on this boat. Is that a boat? No, it's not a boat, it's a building. it's like a famous building in Canada or something, right? Well, there he is. So my Kanye, my Kanye list, but I think a Drake list is also necessary here. And I would love to know yours. Because I realized today while listening to this that this is an amazing album. Very unironically incredible. Like, Hotline Bling is on it.
Call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. I know when that hotline bling. I can only mean one thing. I say bounce that shit like whoa. Yeah, bounce that shit like whoa. Girl, that shit some child's play. Bounce that shit like whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Why you gotta fight with me at Cheesecake? You know I love to go there. Say I'm acting light skin. I can't take you nowhere. It's a place for families to drive Camrys and go to Disney. They don't need to know all of my business. You wild and you super childish. You go to CVS for Kotex and my Bugatti. Don't make me dig it back to the hood. Don't make me dig it back. I say bounce that shit like whoa. Yeah, bounce that shit like whoa.
I don't know if you're ready. Actually, I don't know if you care about this band. But we did see them together at a very iconic concert. It makes me feel a lot. This is the first CD I ever owned, and now I own it again. I do remember being like 7 years old and dancing around my house with my Walkman to this CD and like opening this and seeing this, like.
Tell me how you want it to be. Tell me, baby.
My loneliness is killing me, and I must confess, I still believe, I'm not with you, I lose my mind, give me a sign, hit me, baby!
Yeah. Alright, so, this next one, I was... trying to decide because I did have to narrow it down. I did have even more than this, and I had to take away a few because I refused to spend more than $150. So I was actually debating whether to get Taylor Swift's 1989 or this CD, and I don't know what was wrong with me, but I came to and realized obviously Ariana is the choice.
It's not her.
I'm really upset at myself, honestly, for even debating it, but.
Like, look how freaking cute this is. Okay, Ariana's first studio album. Yours truly, it is a masterpiece. I love her so much. Look at her.
I feel like my heart.
Best is yet to come.
Thank you.
Obviously. I'm going to do so much to this. Volumes 1 and 2. I was sitting there trying to pick one, like which one I liked better, and then I fucking slap some sense into myself because there's no way I was walking away without either of these. Like, Don't Stop Believin' and Defying Gravity are on this one, and Don't Rain on My Parade and I Am Telling You are on this one. Like, there's no, and Crush, like by David Archuleta. I hope so. I really hope so. ABBA, yes, it is ABBA Gold, but not only is it ABBA Gold, it is signed by all of the members of ABBA. Signed!
Thank you.
this is my present to you. And you'll get it in 5 months, unless you decide to come visit me. So yeah, there it is. My haul. Is there anything else I wanted to say? Probably. See ya next week.